Hello, and welcome to this video about using the quadratic formula. Today we'll learn what the quadratic formula is, when you use it, and how it's applied to find roots in quadratic equations. Let's start by talking about quadratic equations. A quadratic equation in standard form is written as ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, where a doesn't equal 0, and a, b, and c are all real numbers. The quadratic formula is an algebraic equation that helps solve any quadratic equation. The formula is x is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. By substituting in given values for the variables a, b, and c, you can solve for x using the quadratic formula. Solving for x gives us solutions for the quadratic equation. These solutions are also called roots. Let's consider the quadratic equation x squared plus x minus 6 equals 0, and use the quadratic formula to find solutions for x. First, identify the values for the variables a, b, and c in the quadratic equation. Since the first term, x squared, is the same as 1x squared, the value for a is equal to 1. In the second term, x, the value for b is also equal to the coefficient of 1. And since the last term is negative 6 or minus 6, the value for c is equal to negative 6. Next, substitute the values for a, b, and c into the quadratic formula. So let's write out our quadratic formula again so that we remember it. X is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And now we're going to plug in our a, b, and c into this equation. So x is equal to negative 1 plus or minus the square root of 1 squared minus 4 times 1 times negative 6 all over 2 times 1. From here, solve for x using the quadratic formula. So all we have to do is simplify. So we're going to leave the negative 1 right here for now and move on to this part. So we have the square root of 1 squared is 1, minus 4 times 1 times negative 6 is negative 24, so minus negative 24 over 2 times 1 is 2. 1 minus negative 24 is the same as saying 1 plus 24, which is 25. The square root of 25 is 5, so we have negative 1 plus or minus 5 over 2. And now we're going to break this part into two different equations. So we're going to have negative 1 plus 5 over 2. Remember, x is equal to this, so this is one of our values for x. So negative 1 plus 5 is 4, over 2 is 2. And then for our other value of x, we're going to do x is equal to negative 1 minus 5 over 2. Negative 1 minus 5 is negative 6, over 2 is negative 3. So the roots for this quadratic equation are 2 and negative 3. In the example we just looked at, there were two possible solutions or roots for x. Quadratic functions can have two solutions, one solution, or no real solutions for x. To figure out how many solutions a quadratic equation has, look at the discriminant in the quadratic formula. The discriminant is the portion of the quadratic formula that's beneath the square root symbol. It's the part that's read as b squared minus 4ac. When simplified, the discriminant can be a positive number, a negative number, or zero. And its sign tells us how many solutions the quadratic equation has. When the discriminant is positive, then the quadratic equation has two real solutions. When it's negative, then it has no real solutions. And when the discriminant is zero, then the quadratic equation has exactly one real solution. In the previous example, the discriminant was 25. Since it's a positive number, we know that the quadratic equation has two real solutions, which is what we found when we worked it out. Let's look at another example. Consider the quadratic equation 10x squared minus 9x plus 6 equals 0. And let's use the quadratic formula to find the solutions for x. First, we need to identify the values for the variables a, b, and c in the quadratic equation. Our first term, 10x squared, tells us that a is equal to 10. Our second term, negative 9x, tells us that the value of b is negative 9. And our third term, plus 6, tells us that c is equal to 6. Now we're going to use the quadratic equation to solve this problem. So our formula is x is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Now remember, writing out formulas helps you remember it. So whenever you can, it's a really helpful thing to do. Now all we have to do is plug in our numbers for our variables. So negative b, b is negative 9, so be careful when plugging it in. You need to make sure you have the negative 9. Plus or minus the square root of b squared is negative 9 squared minus 4 times a is 10 times c is 6 all over 2 times 10, which is equal to minus a negative is equal to a positive. So we're going to have positive 9 right here, plus or minus the square root of negative 9 squared is 81. And then 4 times 10 times 6 is 240. So we have minus 240 all over 2 times 10 is 20. So this gives us 9 plus or minus negative 159 over 20. And we can stop right here because we see our discriminant is negative 159. Negative numbers don't have real square roots because a square is either positive or zero. So remember, if the discriminant is negative number, then there are no real solutions to the equation. So we can stop right here. Our answer is that there is no real solutions for x. Now it's your turn. I'm going to give you a quadratic equation, and you need to use the quadratic formula to identify the possible roots for x. 9x squared plus 12x plus 4 equals 0. Pause the video here and try it yourself. And when you're done, resume the video and we'll go over everything together. Let's take a look at this one together. Start by identifying the values for a, b, and c. Based on the equation, we can see that a is equal to 9, b is equal to 12, and c is equal to 4. Next, substitute the values for a, b, and c into the quadratic formula. So remember, the formula is x is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And then we just take our numbers up here and plug them in for all our variables. So we have negative 12 plus or minus the square root of 12 squared minus 4 times 9 times 4 all over 2 times 9. So this simplifies to negative 12 plus or minus the square root of 12 squared is 144 minus 4 times 9 is 36 times 4 is 144 all over 2 times 9 is 18. So then we have negative 12 plus or minus the square root of 0 over 18. The square root of 0 is 0, so all we have is negative 12 plus or minus 0 over 18. And if you add or subtract 0, that's not going to change your number at all, so this is really the same as negative 12 over 18, which we can then simplify by dividing both the numerator and denominator by 3. So that'll give us negative 4 over 6. And we can simplify that one more time by dividing both by 2 to get negative 2/3. So x is equal to negative 2/3. And that's our root for this equation. Quadratic functions occur in many real-world situations. One example is shooting a cannonball out of a cannon. When you do this, it goes up and then it comes back down in the shape of a parabola. Since a parabola is the graph of a quadratic function, you can use the equation for the path the cannonball follows to answer questions about its time, speed, and distance. There are lots of other problem-solving instances in which quadratic equations are helpful. Understanding them helps us apply mathematical concepts in the real world. I have one more problem for you to try. Let's take a look at a word problem that we can solve by using the quadratic formula. A high school physics club shoots a model rocket into the air from 12 feet above the ground. The initial velocity of the rocket is 19 feet per second. The equation h equals negative 10x squared plus 19x plus 12 can be used to show the height of the rocket after x seconds. How long does it take for the rocket to hit the ground? We can solve this problem by applying the quadratic formula to the equation given in the scenario. This problem's a little bit more challenging, but I know you can handle it. Pause the video here and try it yourself, and when you're done, we'll go over it together. Let's take a look at this one. In this scenario, we are looking for the amount of time it takes for the rocket to reach the ground. The height, h, at ground level is 0 feet. Therefore, we can replace 0 for h in the equation. So we can rewrite it as 0 equals negative 10x squared plus 19x plus 12. And now it looks like our quadratic equation in standard form, just with our 0 on the left side instead of the right side. So now that we understand that our equation is really just in standard form, we can identify the values for a, b, and c. Based on our equation, we see that a is equal to negative 10, b is equal to 19, and c is equal to 12. Now we can substitute these values into our quadratic formula. So we have the formula again is x is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Now we can plug in our numbers. So we have x is equal to negative b, so negative 19, plus or minus the square root of 19 squared minus 4 times negative 10 times 12 all over 2 times negative 10. So this is equal to negative 19 plus or minus the square root of 19 squared is 361 minus 4 times negative 10 times 12 is negative 480 over 2 times negative 10 is negative 20. So this is equal to negative 19 plus or minus the square root of 361 minus negative 480 is the same as saying plus 480. So the square root of 841, that's what you get when you add those two numbers together, over negative 20. So this is equal to negative 19 plus or minus the square root of 841 is 29 over negative 20. And now from this step, we're going to take this equation and break it into two separate equations because of this plus or minus. So we're going to have x is equal to negative 19 plus 29 over negative 20. And we're also going to have x is equal to negative 19 minus 29 over negative 20. Negative 19 plus 29 is equal to 10 over negative 20, simplifies to negative 1 half. And over here, negative 19 minus 29 is negative 48 over negative 20. Our negatives will cancel each other out, and if we divide both the numerator and denominator by 4, we'll get 12 over 5. So the solutions to this equation are x equals negative 1 half and x equals 12 over 5. Now that we have the two roots for x, we must interpret what they mean in the context of the word problem. Recall that x stands for seconds, measuring the amount of time it takes for the model rocket to hit the ground. Time is measured with positive numbers, not negative numbers. Therefore, the negative root of x does not apply to this scenario. Based on the positive solution for x, the amount of time that it will take for the rocket to hit the ground is 12 over 5 seconds. Great work! I hope this video about using the quadratic formula was helpful. Thanks for watching and happy studying!